It doesn't matter who we are. What matters is our plan.
So, where we're going now is we're going to go to lower basement place now. I'm just hoping this dragon don't pop out. There we go, it's coming. Get out of the way. Right, I should be able to get this way. This fire breath shouldn't be able to reach me from where it is. So this is the basement key. This leads you into Lower Undead Burg, where things just get a little bit bad. This is quite a hard area when you first go into it. It's quite of a shock after being where you were. You've got to get used to the agility of the new enemies down here. To do backflips and stuff here and dodge his sword swipes. So, and there's dogs down here too. So first of all, what you want to do is go up these stairs. Open this gate. And that will lead you to a new shortcut here. And yeah, there's these guys too. Yeah, so I'm gonna go here anyway, just for the sake of it, just so you know where we are. So it connects back to this bonfire. It's a good bonfire to kindle. Although I don't need it really. It's already got 10 on it anyway, so if it were a 5 bonfire, it'd be a good one to kindle. Definitely. So I'm just leaving the weapons because I can't be bothered with them really. I've got so much that I want to feed this dragon that gives you souls. And you don't get a right what souls to feed him, this dragon it. So there's no point. So this is Lower Undead Burg. You can see these dogs. Not particularly the worst enemies down here. Apart the dogs. You can quite easily deal with them. But you do have worse enemies down here. So we're not going to go down there. People will start popping out the doors. If you go down here.
Somebody. Please let me out of here. Somebody, anybody, help me. Unlock the door.
Damn, I'm finished. How did this ever happen?
So that mystery key that we got opens this door. And in here is a mage.
Brilliant. You opened the door for me. Thank you. I'm saved. I thought I might never escape. I am Griggs of Vinheim, a sorcerer of the school. I am much obliged for your assistance. Thanks to you, I may now resume my travels.
So, I think there is a corpse there that has some stuff on it. I'd avoid trying to kill him. So go, it's the best way. And you should be able to get the sorcery stuff there. Sorcery is actually quite good.
Hello, I'm fine. I will rest a while, then return to Firelink Shrine. I have my sorcery. and I will be more cautious next time. Besides, I have an important task at hand.
So that guy will now sell your sorceries at Firelink the Shrine. So if you want to at this point, go get the Soul Arrows and that Titanite Demon, or Titanite, whatever it is, that demon anyway, you can kill him with the Soul Arrows if you want to become a mage. So there's a lot of guys on that side. That's what happened. I got ambushed and totally forgot about them. I don't know how you forget about that sort of. All we want is that soul in the corner, really. I'm sorry, it's soul. If it's certain it is. You're a bastard when. If you get a load of strikes on you with that flame, it does some serious amount of damage. Like I said, parrying is alright when you've got one person, but here you'll get a lot of doors that open up, and when these doors open, you're going to get ganged up on by quite a few people. All you need to do is go far enough. I'd do a runner point. Cornering them is a very good idea. Those aren't so bad, them guys, in comparison to the others. So there is stuff in these buildings. And then no one jumps on you in them. Make sure you have full health. This is where some more decide to jump out on you. There's also a dog down there. I'm not sure if it's worth it first. All come chasing you. Oh, nice. Cornering, like I said, cornering is a good idea. There's only three of them. They actually killed me quite a few times the first time I came down here. Do a lot less damage than I expected him to. Seems though the hollows do. This guy should have some humanity. Oh no, it's large, so. Beach mask. Never used them, but it's worth getting them if you're a collector. So there is a boss behind this door. But as long as you're quick, this boss shouldn't really get you. There's some stairs on your left hand side. So you really want to be running straight up them stairs to get out of the way, because there's dogs as well in here. So, right, so I lost all my soul and my humanity. I've had to gear up for this. On Game Plus, it seems a bit harder and taking more damage off you. You might not have to do this on your first playthrough. The art of it is getting rid of them dogs first. Fairly similar to another enemy that I faced. Not that hard, the biggest part is the dogs. But like I say, you might not have to gear up with that sort of armour against him. So I died a few times trying to get him. You need to come in here, get the key to the depths. There's no other way to get the key to the depths, and that's where we want to go next. We need to go down into Blight Town. I think we've got everything around here, so I think we should just head down the stairs now. So that guy there, but as you know, people like jumping us in this game, so we have got a guy on the left hand side here that's going to jump on us before. Just there, look. So this is first leads you down to the depths, which is where we want to go next. Before that, we want to open up an exit here and a trader that's further up. There's a guy on here that fires arrows at you, so do be careful with him. I'm just going to switch back to my electric made lightning weapon, so do enjoy using it. So you've got a merchant here.
You still have your senses about you. Then why won't you buy some of my moss? I need your souls.
So she sells quite a lot of stuff. Homewood buttons. Always useful. They're useful to the self humanity as well. It's useful, but I don't expect you to ever really run out of humanity. Although it's one of the most useful items in the game. Just arrows, really. But if you go down this way, you're on the health. So this leads you right back down to Firelink Shrine. You get here, this here is the mage.
I regret meeting you under such compromising circumstances. At least we both made it back unscathed. Incidentally, would you care to learn any sorceries? You're clearly talented, and besides, I owe you. Of course, we will require some materials, but I'm happy to teach you some elementary spells. Are you interested?
So you want to say yes?
Splendid. Very well. I am pleased to have a chance to give something back. Well then, let's get started straight away.
So you can purchase spells from him. Although I've got every single one of these spells. And they're not the best spells in the game, but they'll do you very good in this part of the game, especially the Great Heavy Soul Arrows in particular. I get the Great Soul and probably the Great Heavy, but if you want to get the achievement for all sorceries, you'll have to buy all of them.
What's that?
Yeah, so we're going to go back and go down the depths now. A very treacherous area. Very poisonous. Depths actually, I think it's White Town, which is probably the area. Depths ain't so bad, but it is still bad. Ow! She fucking didn't jump on me. It's always worth killing this rat, just in case. Gives you some free mana. Because we're off in this gate and the shortcut's now red, so let's get down to the depths. Still a treacherous area, but it's not as bad as White Town. White Town is the next area that we're going to go down. Remember this archer on here. He will shoot to kill. You don't really need to kill them now. They won't come after you if you come down this way to the depths. But if you do choose to just for the extra souls, go ahead. open to do so. So my priority down here is getting to the first bonfire. Hiding down here. As you go down these stairs, on your right hand side there's a guy that's going to jump you, and he's going to come straight at you, so you're going to have people coming from you at both sides, because we've waited here, he's obviously coming forward. So you don't want to go running in this area. There's a lot of enemies around here. Probably the worst part about it. Soul arrows can actually help you here if you've got some soul arrows. In my case, I've got homing soul arrows. You really want to try and avoid just taking them all on at once. Very much so. It's alright, taking a few on. Two guys just up here. The guy's already gone. So down here you will see that big bastard down there. And there's also a dog down here. So you want to get rid of that dog before you're going to go to that big bastard down there. Some crystal soul arrows to take care of him. So as soon as he sees you, he's gonna come up here. So there is a secret way down here, but I'm not going to go down here at this particular point because I really want to muck the bonfire before I start doing things like that. So my first priority is to unlock the bonfire. Down here you've got a dog. There. Homing soul arrows. If you haven't got them, soul arrows will do. Okay, I've got a ring. It does help me. In the water move quickly, but I can use it because there's only that little bit. So you want to go left into this room.
You, yes, you, here, over here, please, you must help me.
So in here you've got a guy in the corner and he's got promances. I would advise not to swipe with your sword because you could kill him. So just roll into these barrels. You see him, he's in there, he's trapped in that barrel. all the barrels.
Thank you. I would have been a supper without you. Been eaten alive, I shudder to think. Thank you. Thank you dearly. I am Luentius, Lord the Great Spawn. I will not forget my debt to you. Oh, hello there. I'm fine, thanks to you.
So he'll go back to Firelink Shrine and he'll sell you bromances. It's very useful. He'll upgrade your bromance, the power of your bromances too. So you go down here, I don't think there's anything in particular down here. So, stupid dad has led me back here. I did get the souls, but then I went down here and died again. There's a guy around this corner, so do make sure to go around this corner. Right, there's something above you here. It's a slime. So what you really want to do is sort of roll, try and get into some sort of there you go. Now these, they'll die if you fire them. Fireballs, obviously, aren't that good for it. So there's lots of them on the ceiling here. This is the door. They never fell on me before down here. Made a bit of a meal of it, but I've got here in the end. What we're going to do here, we're just going to go back to kill a big rat. And anything in here, your best bet is to get anything curse resistant. The Crimson set is actually quite good for curse resistance. Obviously I've got armor that you don't have. The Havel armour is very good for curse resistances too. This can actually have curse resistance. This hat, no matter how stupid it looks, it's got ridiculous curse resistance. I'm not going to wear it because I shouldn't need that much curse resistance on there. So what I am going to do is I'm just gonna go for the Havel helm. There's any other ones that really have this resistance? Yeah, that's it. So, Crimson set's quite good with it. Got this blood shield. The thing about it is you don't get it until a bit later on in the game. That actually takes off, it gives you curse resistance. It adds 50% to your curse resistance, so it does very well for you. So I'll show you what combustion there, all my resistances go up with that shield. It's such a brilliant shield and this sort of situation. But you won't feel the benefit from this shield in the game plus. So, where am I going? I remember. Going down this way, we're going to get a rat. My mobility in the water is quite bad here, but this is what you would have to do, so I can put on the ring and boost my mobility. Bags to the point, it's not going to help me right about right now. Because there's not a lot of what deep water in this area. So if I go down here, nice little secret passageway. Here's why we're going down here, there's a big rat. Now you can get into this room in other ways, but from here, especially if you're a sorcerer or got any sort of magic, it's really easy to sort of just pick him up from here. And there you go, he's dead. Simple as that. I don't believe there's anything actually up here. The only thing I want to do is go down. Just make sure you clear this room out first. At this point, you don't really want to die. So, there's two ways out. Go down the waterfall. go down the waterfall, you can go this way. Do watch out for these frogs, because these are things that can be pretty curse. Quite a bit stronger on this game. We've got a rat here. Now, it is worth, probably actually at this point, going all the way around, because there's no more rats. As long as we've got curse resistances, we can probably do this with quite a lot of ease. So, in human form, there's actually a guy that pops up. So I might come back down in human form, now I'm not. These guys are things that give you curse, but I've got quite a big threshold of curse resistance. They shouldn't do anything to me. Look how little damage it does to the curse resistance. If you get cursed, what it does, it cuts your life in half. You also need a stone, I think it's a purging stone it's called, to release the curse. You never need a lie. Little door through here at the top you need to go through. Yeah, I believe there's a sage somewhere over here. You can get across there. Watch out because there's loads of little holes like this that'll get you. Show you where they all are. And that should be the end of it. There shouldn't be anything else left. Should be all the items in here. We'll come back down here as human and then eventually go to the boss. Might do it just before the boss, so I can just go directly to the boss. So if you run out of combustion with these things, you best plan. Out your fire attacks, the only other thing that you can do. Is equip your fire bombs. You can buy them. That's the only other thing that you can do in this situation. Is that one that will jump on you if you're not careful. God, does little to make for no damage to them. So you've got a guy here.
Aye, shall I? And good day to you. I'm Donald of Zena. I'm just, well, a peddler of sorts. I adore trinkets and oddities, so I trade for them.
So he sells some useful items, I believe. Bottomless box, but I've already got one. Some crystal weapons. The crystal shield would do you very well at this particular point in the game, but it doesn't last forever and you cannot repair it. Arrows and some armour that I've never bought from him. Never bought any armour from him.
Well, that is a shame, but no matter. No, not to worry. Come back again.
I just don't need anything from him. I don't think there's anything else in here. There's not. So if you go up these stairs, that should be that area completely done for the moment. We will be back down. Let's move you out. Go back up these stairs. We'll go back in this room. So, next room that I want to go in. You can actually sneak up on this guy. I don't need to go down that way. In fact, I do want to use my souls. Gives me use to a new weapon. I've wanted to get this to 36 for a reason, because I do have the Black Knight Grey Axe. One of the most brutal weapons you can get. Extraordinary reach. So rats do give you humanity. Shield does give you poison resistance, I believe, as well, so just leave you on, because the rats will poison you down here. I think they'll try this axe out, to be honest with you. See how they're just giving me that poison there. And they're getting by. Quite a heavy weapon though, I think. Moron, if you like that. There's no boss in here, so you don't have to worry. So, this mage is the guy that we want to get here. So, what you really want to do is try and lure these rats to you. The mage shouldn't be able to hit from here. I might be able to hit now. What I want to do is lure these bats to me without luring that guy. Probably kill these from here, probably worth the doing. If you have soul arrows, I would be able to do the same. Don't know where he's gone, there's also another rat. Yeah. You need to do this bit, because he will fire stuff at you. Again, then look. It's basically what all you want to come here for is to kill him. Now, what I do believe is you don't need to draw down these, because this takes pretty much. This actually takes you to where the room where the big rat was. Two other ways. It's this line, eh? You just gotta watch out for them holes. It's also another reason why you should keep the curse resistance stuff on. Because if you do fall down, you're gonna get to these guys. But I don't think there's actually anything up there now though, so you can go back. Get some humanity in there. I'm going to take human form and I'm going to come back down here. The guy that actually turns up down here, I didn't actually kill him the first place, so I'm gonna make sure I kill him this time around. prepare for that. These speed drop contract cards. Well, I'm not going to do this for now. Just going to get some humanity and come back down. This time head that down the ladders. This is where you need to be going anywhere. Hopefully you do not lose a lot of health against this guy that comes. Just watch that guy on the roof, that slime. Fine ball up there. Yeah, so this is where the guy pops up. So we do bring the careful. Let's see how you kill everything. Before you can get him. I think he just drops something. Does he drop something? You get humanity from these guys if you kill them. Some of them also give you item drops as well. So this is the area that we want to go now. So now we're going to go face the next block. So if you don't kill that mage will fire from you from up there. That's where we killed him. So that's why it's important to kill that mage. He does not respawn. It's also very good for us. Show sure there weren't any items down this way. Oh, so I can summon someone as well. Didn't know that I could do that. It's always worth summoning something if you can. Heavy crossbow and heavy bolt arrows. People will come in handy at this point in the game. But I do think that makes summon is always better. You're always a good person to summon. You can face a boss. You can gear up now. Not gonna make the same mistakes that you saw. Now this dragon, or this thing, I'm going to face now. I didn't do it the first time around, but I'm going to be trying to do it this time around. But chop off its tail and get a special weapon. Our priority is getting behind this dragon and getting its tail off, because I do not want to miss it again. Our solitaire's got it distracted to be able to do it. Just putting the armour on, I like to sort of go around in now.